Hey everybody and welcome back to another Darkfall video. So today we're going to be looking at version 1.2 of the Darkfall VFX Nodes. If you've not already seen the VFX Nodes, if you click up here there'll be a link so you can go ahead and check out the first video. But in this video I'm going to show you some changes and some of the new additions. But first let's go ahead and download the add-on. So to do that, click the link in the description below and it'll take you to our blog. And then if you scroll down, there'll be a link here that you can click which will take you to the new version 1.2. And for anyone who's not downloaded an add-on before, this is what it looks like. This is the script. But all you need to do is go over here to download, click this download button. And as soon as you do that, it'll download the .py file. So then just save this to a folder that you will remember. Then we can go ahead and open up Blender. Now we can go to Edit, then to Preferences, then go down to Add-ons. And if you already have the previous version, let's go ahead and search for it. So this is the old version, let's go ahead and remove it. And then we can go ahead and install from file. Go ahead and navigate to the folder that you saved this in. So I'm going to select this version 1.2, install from file. Then we can go ahead and activate it. And if you've got the settings to auto save, just save it. And there we go. So let's go ahead and change this from the 3D view to the compositor window. We can go ahead and check use nodes, and then we'll go ahead and delete these nodes. Then let's switch to the Darkfall VFX node panel. So the first thing you'll notice that the panels have now been arranged into categories. So we have artistic effects, the eye effects, and we have some tools for you to use as well. We've got a couple of new additions with the gradient node and the scanline generator, and we'll take a look at these in a second. And we also have a render panel setting up here as well. So there's a few new additions just to tidy it up and make it look nicer. So let's check out the tools. The first one is the gradient node. So by default, the information is now collapsed. So let's go ahead and click the gradient node. And it's pretty simple. It's just literally a blend. But if we wanted to add this node to the compositor without this button here, what we would need to do is change this window to the texture node editor. Then we need to change the texture type to brush. Then we'd need to add a new texture, and you'd have to name this. You'd have to then click Use Nodes, then select this one and delete it, Shift A, go down to Textures, add in a blend, connect this up. Then you'd need to change this to Vertical. Then you need to go back to the compositor. Then you'd need to Shift A, go to Input, add in a texture, and then finally you'd have to actually define the texture. So it's a lot of processes and a lot of steps in just to add a blend to the compositor, and I thought I'd take out a lot of that work so you guys can add in a gradient anytime you want. You can also move it around and also scale it up if you need to. And again, I hope it speeds up the workflow. I mean, as you can see, it does speed up the workflow, but how often you'll use this, I don't know. I mean, maybe you guys let me know in the comments if you find this useful. So then the next addition we have is the scanline generator. And you can use this for a couple of different effects, maybe a sci-fi sort of scanline effect. But one of the reasons I created this was for the glitch node. So let's just get rid of this node here. Add in the glitch node, add in some additional nodes, connect this up. Let's go ahead and load up a movie clip. And then let's just enable the backdrop. There we go. So for this effect to work, we need a glitch image, which you can use your own glitch image, use whatever you want. But I thought it'd be nice if we have this scanlines node here. Just drop this in. Let's just delete this image, now we're not going to use it. So it just generates a barcode or a glitch kind of image, and if we plug this into the glitch image, and then of course we need to play around with this, so I'm just going to give these a few random values. So something like this, and we get the same effect without needing to add a texture image if you don't want to download an image. Or so again, it's a pretty simple node which we can use with this glitch node, or you can use it on its own futuristic scanline overlay effect. I mean, there's a few different variations, but just to see how this node works, if we go back to the texture node editor and then let's change this to the scanlines texture that's now created. So we can see it's a blend node like we did before, but with a whole bunch of math nodes, and it's not perfect. If you guys want to play around with this, so if anybody wants to play around with this and try and improve it, I guess I'll be open to ideas, because it is a bit clunky and it is a bit heavy. So, you know, you guys want to improve this, go ahead and do that. So there are the two new additions, the Scanline Generator and the Gradient Node. We also have a Render Settings panel. So if we click this, we can see we have a whole bunch of options. And essentially, it's all the options that we need to render out any effect that we create. So we first have the Render Video button, but first we need to change a few settings. We can set the video resolution, just as we could over here, like this. Then you can go ahead and set the start and end frame, along with the frame rate. Then you can set the output where you want this video to be saved. So by default, it's going to be a PNG image sequence. And of course, we can change these settings here. But if we want to render this out as a movie clip, we would click this and change it to FFmpeg video. So for the container, you can leave it on Matroska, but I prefer to use MPEG-4. So I'm going to use that. And then we have the color management. So we can use the standard look or we could use Filmic. So once you're happy with the settings, go ahead and render this out. Now, one more thing that I added, when you select a node, we just close this down. We now have a properties window here. We click this. So instead of having to scroll in and seeing what they do and then trying to do the values and then moving it out of the way, you now just have this panel here. So I don't know if you'll use this panel a lot. So let me know if you think this is a good addition or not. So that's it for this week's update. Hopefully I'll have some more updates for you next week. If you guys are enjoying this, let me know what you think in the comments below. So I'm still trying to learn a whole bunch of new things, and I'm thankful for all the help I'm getting from the Blender community, so you guys are awesome. So hopefully you enjoyed this video. As always, thank you for watching, and I will see you next time.